Now we have plotted the loading diagram as we have calculated all the forces acting at point A, B and C. The first, this diagram is the forces representing forces along y-axis in vertical plane. The bearing, the shaft is supported at two bearings at point D and point E. At point B, we have obtained that force of 1595.8 newton is acting along negative y-axis. At point A, there is no force along y-axis. And at point C, there is radial component along y-axis that is acting from pinion to gear and then finally to shaft at point C. We have two reactions at point D and point E. We can now, using simple static equilibrium equations, we can find out the reactions at point D and point E. The reactions at point E is negative, so it will be from top to bottom along negative y axis. We have assumed upward positive y, so that is why it is negative minus 1182.22 newton. And this is 1040.19 newton. So this we can calculate from static equilibrium. Now we can draw the Bannerman diagram. 1040 into 150, that is the distance between point D and B. So this is the bending moment at point B. And from here we can make use of the force acting at point E. So now we can mark the bending moment, this force multiplied by the distance 150 as mentioned, written here. So we have got these two points, there is no force in between. So now we can connect these two lines to complete our bending moment diagram. So maximum bending moment in this case is at point C. So similarly, we can plot the loading diagram in horizontal plane, that is along forces along z-axis, and then we can draw the bending moment diagram in this plane, that is yz plane. So this is basically xy plane. This bending moment is also in xy plane. This is a horizontal plane, or it is yz plane. The bending moment here is in yz plane. The forces shown in this horizontal plane, they are along z-axis. So now there is no force along z-axis at point B because it is all vertical downward pulley belt is there. So we have force along positive z-axis at A, that is there through pulley at belt tension. We have this tangential component of force on gear, which is being transmitted to point C on the shaft. So it is 4774.65 newton. These two forces, again two reactions we can calculate using static equilibrium equations. So we got these two equations, both these two reactions both are negative, so it means they will be acting from top to bottom, that is along minus y axis. We have drawn the bending moment diagram. This force multiplied by this distance, the reaction multiplied by this distance will give you bending moment at point A, and from this force to this we can get the bending moment at point C. So we have obtained these two points, then we have connected all these points through lines, and then finally we got this bending moment diagram. So now what we have bending moment in xy plane, we have bending moment in yz plane. With the help of these two bending moment, we can find out what is the value of bending moment, resultant bending moment, that will be acting on this shaft that we have to design in a plane which is neither xy plane or yz plane. It is some plane which is making some angle with the other planes. So we can calculate value of resultant bending moment at point B, A and C using, because we have bending moment in xy plane and yz plane, both plane are perpendicular to each other. So now we can make use of simple Pythagoras theorem, that is squaring, adding and then taking root to get value at a point. So MB, that is bending moment at a point B, is given by square root at point in z direction here in horizontal plane, and y direction here in vertical plane, that is xy plane. So similarly we can get the other two values. So we calculated values at point of bending, resultant bending moment at point A, B is this, A is this and C is this. Now it is important to note that bending moment at point A is maximum. So now we have to compare this bending moment with the twisting moment. So twisting moment is maximum at point C and point A. So point C bending moment is less as compared to point B. So that is why we will take we will design shaft at point A, taking values at point A, that is the bending moment is also maximum and twisting moment is also maximum. In some of the cases where the situation may not be that clear that it maximum value of bending moment and twisting moment both are appearing at the same point, in that case we have to design the shaft for two or three different points where we may realize that here you can we may get value of maximum resultant bending and twisting moment, or otherwise we can calculate equivalent twisting moment if we are using maximum shear stress theory, and then finally maximum value of equivalent twisting moment can be used in maximum shear stress theory to get the final answer. So now we in this particular situation we will use we'll be using value of MA, that is 1219876 Newton mm, and twisting moment of 716197.2, and these two values are to be used in maximum shear stress theory to calculate or to design the shaft, which is given by pi mt. Instead of mt we can write down this under root of ma square plus mt c square divided by pi, it is 16, pi d cube, that is equal to tau d. Now tau d here, if it is given then there is not an issue. If it is not given you can use any assumed value for any material, suitable material. C30 you can use, you can use ASME code, then whatever value of tau d, this is approximately 80 megapascal, you will get. You design the shaft for 80 megapascal and whatever value you will get, slice this, that will be your final answer for this problem. Thank you.